and watch us where we go. And help us to be wise in times when we don't know.
When stars go out each night,
eterna stella sei, nella mia preghiera,
let this be our prayer,
quanta fede c'è.
Faith so we'll be saved.
Sogniamo un mondo senza più violenza, un mondo di giustizia e di speranza.
give thanks to the church.
Let us pray. Loving God, we have gathered here this morning, united by the wonderful gift of your love and the precious gift of faith that you've given to all of us. As we come this morning to live into your loving hands, through your servant and our brother Matthew, as he desired to live out the good news in his life, be a witness to the risen Christ. We now beseech you to embrace him in the fullness of the kingdom and glory of the resurrection. And as always in faith, we ask you this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Please be seated for the proclamation of the word.
A reading from the Book of Wisdom. The souls of the just are in the hand of God, and no torment shall touch them. They seem in the view of the foolish to be dead, and their passing away was thought in the picture, and their going forth from us utter destruction. But they are in peace. For if in the eyes of men indeed they be punished, Yet is there hope full of immortality. Chastise the little, they shall be greatly blessed. Because God tried them and found them worthy of himself. As gold in the furnace, he proved them. And as sacrificial offerings, he took them unto himself. Those who trust in him shall understand truth, and the faithful shall abide with him in love. Because grace and mercy are with his holy ones, and his care is with his elect. The word of the Lord.
Thank you.
There they crucified him with him, two others, one on either side.
Jesus in the middle. Standing by the cross of Jesus were his mother's sister, Mary the wife of Cleophas, and Mary Magdalene. When Jesus saw his mother and the disciple whom he loved, he said to his mother, "Woman, behold your son." And he said to the disciple, "Behold your mother." And from then on, the disciple took her into his home. After this, aware that everything was not finished, in order that the scriptures might be fulfilled, Jesus said, "I thirst." There was a vessel filled with common wine. They put a sponge soaked in it, spring of hyssop, and put it up to his mouth. When he had taken the wine, he said, "It is finished." He bowed his head. He handed over the spirit. Now, since it was preparation day, in order that the bodies might not remain on the cross for the Sabbath, and the Sabbath day of the week was a solemn one, the Jews asked Pilate that their legs be broken and they be taken down. So the soldiers came and broke the legs of the first and of the other one who was crucified with Jesus. But when they came to Jesus and saw that he was already dead, they did not break his legs. But one soldier thrust his lance into his side, and immediately blood and water flowed out. And an eyewitness has testified, and his testimony is true. He knows that he is speaking the truth, so that you may also come to believe. This happened so that the scripture might be fulfilled, not a bone of it will be broken. And again, another passage says, they will look upon him whom they have pierced. After this, Joseph of Arimathea, secretly, a disciple of Jesus from the fear of the Jews, asked Pilate if he could remove the body of Jesus. And Pilate permitted it. So he came and took his body. Nicodemus, the one who had come to live night, also came, bringing a mixture of myrrh and aloes, weighing about 100 pounds. My sisters and brothers, the gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
You and I come together to share. It's so very important that we can come together. Yet under my faith and law, coming together to share the proclamation of the word, the celebration of the Lord. Reminding us in the power of God's love, the gift. John's Gospel describes for us this morning an awful terrible scene of the crucifixion of Jesus. You may recall that the Romans used crucifixion for many reasons, but it was limited to slaves and rebels because it was so horrible that a Roman citizen could not be crucified. And when they crucified someone, they did the absolute best they could to make sure it was as painful and as agonizing as possible. So John gives us a glimpse of there Jesus on the cross with his mother and Mary of Cleophas, and we think John the Evangelist there watching the horror, the agony that he was suffering. Perhaps on this difficult morning, you and I will share a little bit with those sentiments. But when you and I look at the cross, the crucifixion, what do we see? Hatred, violence, agony, vengeance, sinfulness, the list could go on and on and on. And I'm sure that that's what the early community saw as they witnessed the suffering of Jesus. But how about if we suggest looking a little bit beyond that? What else do we see besides the agony and the suffering? receive love, absolute forgiveness and mercy, absolute giving, absolute care and love. Can you imagine what that early community must have gone through those 3 days? That eventually a crowd with the risen Christ who would come back from the tomb. We think that that was such a startling thing. It took some time to understand and recognize all that it really had. One of the things that has always fascinated me was that John tells us that Joseph of Arimathea and Nicodemus the Pharisee came forward to request the body of Jesus, which would have been thrown into a pit, to give him proper burial. We know that both of them were secret disciples of Jesus. And we know that to be a disciple of Jesus at this time was a very dangerous thing. Where did that courage come from? That they would come forward, take the responsibility of burying the body of Jesus. Did they see something more than that scene of crucifixion? And I suggest that you and I, through our eyes of faith, look beyond the agony, the evil, and the hatred. We see something more. More in this human invisible. We see the outpouring of love, the conquering of sin and death, the conquering of evil and hatred, and the gift of everlasting life given to the human race. Isn't it interesting that our loving God used the agony and horror of the cross to be a sign to the entire universe of the wonderful gift of his love? I think in our reading from Paul to the Romans, that's where Paul was coming from. Can anything ever separate us from the love of Jesus Christ? And he begins to list things. And he even lists death. Not even the power of death can frustrate God's love, God's mercy, and God's forgiveness. So I think as we say farewell to Matthew this morning, we need to think about that. And in the tragedy of his departure, we look beyond that and see the wonderful, fabulous gift of God's love. I've not seen Matthew in a while, but I knew him very well when he worked here on our maintenance crew as he was an officer. But I just remember he was kind of a fun, loving kid. He liked to get into things. So I have just wonderful, happy memories about him. And I hope all of you do too. We're grateful for the time he was with us, the good and fine things he shared with us, but we're more grateful because of our faith, the gift of everlasting life, that we know our loving God is already bestowed upon us. Herod and Barnabas, on a very special day of December 4th, 1993, out of faith for Matthew, and out of your love for him, you brought him to St. Leo's Church for the sacrament of baptism. As the saving waters of baptism were poured upon him, all of you knew about the promise of everlasting life that the risen Christ bestowed upon him on that occasion, and now fulfills in our very presence. And part of that celebration was a candle was lighted from the Paschal candle, the sign of resurrection. It was candles burning brightly, this massive Son of yours one day will be given the gift of the resurrection to the risen Christ. I now take this very candle that is presented to you on that day and present it to you again in celebration of your faithfulness, your love, and your guidance to Matthew through each other. May the peace of the risen Christ be with each of you.
And with your spirit.
Our response today is, Lord, hear our prayer. For the vision to see God's love in the world, despite pain, suffering, separation, and loss, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who mourn, the family and friends of Matthew, seek comfort and consolation, heal their pain, and dispel darkness and doubt that come from grief, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Eternal Father, we humbly pray for the sake of our Lord's sorrowful passion, have mercy on Matthew, on us, and the whole world. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For emergency personnel, first responders, firefighters, and our military, may they have the protection of God's grace. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who suffer from mental illness and their families, may they never feel forsaken by God. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all priests and clergy who are ordained to serve our church, that their ministry may be faithful, fruitful, and appreciated by the people whom they serve, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the intentions that we hold within the silence of our hearts. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We now come together to say, offering to the gift of our God, Christ Jesus, our Lord. We invite you now to be seated. Connor Bennett.
Be afraid, I am with you. I have called you each by name.
Oh, working on the Holy Spirit. Give life to all men. You never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, your sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you, by the same Spirit, grace as you make holy these gifts, we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become for us the body and the blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night that he was betrayed, he himself took bread, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, once more giving you thanks. Giving the chalice to his disciples, he said to them, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice, my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sin. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
Amen.
Lord, from every evil, graciously grant each and every day. By the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin, safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope, the coming of our Savior Jesus Christ, for the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours. Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, peace I give you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church. Grace us and grant the peace and unity in accordance with your will to live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
My dear sisters and brothers, may the peace of our Lord Jesus be with each of you.
And with your spirit.
This is my daily bread. This is my daily bread. Your very word spoken to me, and I'm desperate for you,
always so easy to impress. He would get so excited about things. And I convinced him that I could fly. Of course, it only worked if his eyes were shut. He closed his eyes, but he opened them, I'd be in a different place. On Matt's 9th birthday, I left for college. He wasn't thrilled about sharing his birthday with that. After that, we weren't nearly as close. My most recent memories of Matt are how good an uncle he was to my boys, making sure he was there whenever they went to visit Grandma and Grandpa. We went to trips to the zoo, to the arcade, and he even drove down to Maryland to meet Ben when he was born. He was so excited to show off his new apartment in Jinko. He sent me a video walkthrough of his entire house. And he invited us over this summer to go swimming and fishing. It's hard to believe that we're here today. It really doesn't seem real. I'm going to miss my baby brother. And to be honest, I still don't fully understand what happened, but I just want to leave you with a few closing remarks. If you're feeling depressed or isolated, please reach out for my help. There are more people than you realize that love you. If you feel trapped, remember that anything is surmountable. It might not be easy, it can be good. And if you feel compulsive and angry, I'm going to do another match. Also, want to take the opportunity to thank all of you for coming. It's amazing to see how many people love Matt. I hope that you'll come up and share some stories with him. And I also hope that you'll join us for a reception afterwards up with you. I will be addressed.
Okay. Everybody, please bear with me for this. The hardest thing I've ever been in my life, probably. As probably all of you know, I'm Carly Bass' girlfriend. Sage's mom, her stepdad. I want to first thank every single person that's here right now because this means so much. And anywhere in the universe that Matt is looking, I am so glad to see so many people. I'm going to get out of the note right now because I'm wearing this ring that he proposed to me because of Kyle Richmond at Beacon Stand. But it wasn't a real proposal, but it was a fake proposal, but it was a real proposal, so he got free drinks for the whole entire night. He got this ring for free on wish.com, and I said, okay, like, good, don't buy a ring, please buy a bottle if you're going to buy spend that much money. But I mean, it's turning green every other day, but I'm keeping it on forever. Matt loves all of you so, like, he loves so much. And I can't fathom or understand or realize why this happened. But I do know that we can just live through with him. He's always going to be in every single one of our hearts because he loved us all so much more than I've never met somebody who was so passionate about so many things. And I am proud to have loved him, and I am so happy that he loved me. And I never, ever, ever think anything other than that. I love all of you guys in every single possible way for being here for Matt today because he really, really, really needs that support through anything. And I wish I could have given him more, but I'm never going to stop. And so many people in this room have helped me in so many ways throughout this. And I just really, really, really appreciate all of you so much. And thank you all. You are all my family.
in attendance. So we ask that you bring a very, very good time. You are gracious.
Appreciate it.
What's up, buddy? Sorry.